Good evening everyone. So in this video we are going to discuss about additive manufacturing first model, introduction to additive manufacturing. Okay, so here we are going to discuss about the additive manufacturing definition, evolution of additive manufacturing, as well as advantages and disadvantages, and the difference between the additive manufacturing as well as CNC machine. So these are all the things we are going to see about in this video. So first we are going to discuss about, so what is additive manufacturing? So additive manufacturing is the adding the material layer by layer process. Okay, so one more way it is going to be discussed, like layer-based automation fabrication process, making scaled three-dimensional physical object directly from 3D CAD data without using part depending on tools. Okay, so normally this additive manufacturing originally called as 3D printing. So additive manufacturing means what it comes in our mind means build the component layer by layer, that is called as additive manufacturing. So this is also called as 3D printing method and a rapid prototyping method, free form of fabrication and solid free form fabrication, and also 3D printer. So these are all the names this additive manufacturing it will call. Okay, then we are going to see about the evolution of additive manufacturing. So in the evolution of the additive manufacturing, it will be starts in the late 1970s. Okay, so it was introduced in the 1980s in the electronic format. It produces as a 3D object. Okay, so in the 1986, Charles Hull, okay, so he's got the patent in this technology. Okay, so the next in the years 1988, Charles Hull stereolithography was first made available in the public purchase. So until 1996, so many incremental accomplishment further advanced the commercialization of additive manufacturing process. So first it was invented by the Charles Hull. Okay, in 1988 they found the stereolithographic process. Okay, so this is about the evolution of additive manufacturing. So additive manufacturing also called it as layer manufacturing. Why? Because of it going to produce a component by layer, so that it's also called it as layer manufacturing. So other name again like a free form of fabrication, 3D printing, solid free form of fabrication, these are all the other names of additive manufacturing. Then comes into the additive manufacturing. So here in the CAD images provided, according to the CAD images, the component has to be provided over here. So these two images, they are going to made it by different layer thicknesses of the using additive manufacturing process. Okay, so that layer thickness, while seeing the drawing itself, we can able to identify. So the layer thickness we can control, okay, according to our wish, the layer thickness it can be changed over there in the additive manufacturing process. Okay, then comes into the difference between the additive manufacturing and CNC machining. We are going to see in the CNC machining, normally it will be remove the material and it going to got obtain the shape over here. Okay, but in the additive manufacturing process, it will be adding the material and it got the required shape. In the 3D CNC machining process, the wastage will be more compared to the additive manufacturing process. So here the wastage is minimum. Okay, So these are all the main differences over the additive manufacturing and CNC machining. So, and one more thing, in the additive manufacturing, the operating software it will be very easy, but in the CNC machining, while writing the program, it requires some skilled labor. In the additive manufacturing, the structural difference between additive manufacturing as well as the CNC machining. Okay, so here it principle to cut the model into the layers as well as the multi points and then pile upon by one in order to just like a building blocks. It will be adding the material over in the additive manufacturing process. But it comes into the CNC machining process, so it will be reduction in material, okay, through the various tool running the high speed spindle, going to remove the material according to the whatever program written in the input devices, okay. So like this it will be going to cut over the. Then comes into the material differences in the additive manufacturing. They may used for the this one like liquid resins and nylon powder, metal powder, gypsum powder and sandstone powder, wire and sheet. So like this they will be used for as a material over here. But if it comes into the CNC machining, the materials are like cast iron as well as the sheet metal product, so depends upon some of the other iron material they will be using as a material, that means work pieces. Okay, so this is about the difference between the additive manufacturing and CNC machining. And one more difference is the post processing difference. The normally in the post processing does not require over in the additive manufacturing process almost, but after doing this CNC machining operation, post processing it will required like honing as well as lapping process or some of the finishing process they may be used in the after the CNC machining process. Okay, then comes to the commander, we will discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of the AM process. So here first one, design complexity and freedom. In the 3D printing technology, it has expanding the products which involves into the complexity. So here the advantages has been taken up designer and artist to impressive visual effects. It has made some significant impact into the industrial applications. So these applications being developed by the materialized complex components that are providing the both the lighter and stronger than their predecessor. Okay, so this is design and complexity. Then comes into the speed. So here one can do the complex parts within hours, so the speed also it will be maximum. That means compared to conventional machine it will be more speed it will going to produce a new component. Okay, and comes into the next one, customization according to our personal configuration. We are going to create the or make the new component. Okay, so in the 3D printing process allow the mass customization and it will going to personalize the product according to the individual needs and requirement. According to our requirement we are going to customize the product according to that the product has to be manufactured with the layer. Then toolless. So here in industrial manufacturing for low volume and medium volume product, it is costlier, time consuming and labor intensive. Thus, the additive manufacturing can eliminate the need of two products. This is the one more advantages while using of additive manufacturing. And normally while using of additive manufacturing process, the component whatever you are going to manufacture, it will be going to produce a very lightweight component. Okay, so that is the thing. Then in environmental friendly, so here the 3D printing technology, it provides the environmental efficient in terms of manufacturing process by utilizing the 90% of standard material and therefore creating less waste. Then comes into the next thing, no storage cost. So in the 3D printing method, the print products, it going to manufacture the product when they will be needed, so that here no inventory cost. Okay, then comes into the increased employment opportunities. So in the 3D printing technology, it will be increase the demand for designers. The in the CAD model, you are going to make the design, that it will be increases, so that a CAD designer, it will be required. Okay, so and the technicians to operate the 3D printers, so that also the employer will be required, so that employment opportunities, it will be increased over while using of this additive manufacturing process. Then comes into the disadvantage, accuracy. So in the 3D printing is primarily a prototype technology, so that the part created, new part created mainly for test parts. Okay, so that the dimension of the component, it will be precise and accurate reading, check whether it will be feasible or not over here. Then second disadvantage is support material removal. When production volumes are small, the removal of the support material is not a big issue, but the thing is, when volume is high, the removal of support material is the important consideration over here. Then comes into the next disadvantage, limitation of raw material. So in traditional manufacturing, there are wide range of materials we were used in the additive manufacturing technology, can work with only few. So more research, it will be required for this device method enable 3D products for to more durable, to the robust one. And good skills, like a skill, so it is required for application of design and process parameters. And comes into the material cost, the cost of the material is greater than the conventional machining. And then comes into the material properties. Material properties, it is a limited choice of materials are available for additive manufacturing. And intellectual properties, so recently it has found, so that minimum 20 years the patent issue, so after that only they can use come into the public purpose. Then comes into the limitations of size. So here the 3D printing technology currently limited to the size constraints, so very large object still it is not feasible. Only it is going to manufacturing as of now small object, so big object will be very difficult. Then comes into the cost of printer. So the 3D printer cost normally it will be high, so cost is average and as well as high. So that is one of the disadvantages of the this 3D printer as well as our additive manufacturing. Okay, so thank you.